Richard of Shrewsbury, 1473-1483, was the Duke of York. Richard was the second son of Edward IV. Richard's father died when he was just 10 years old. The new king was Richard's brother Edward, but Edward was also just a child, and the two boys were up against a whole bunch of greedy grown-ups. Helpless, they were locked in the Tower of London and never seen again. Sad. Elizabeth of York, we haven't looked at her yet. So, Elizabeth of York, 1466-1503, Queen Elizabeth, daughter of Edward IV and wife of Henry VII, and mother of Henry VIII. A princess of York, Elizabeth was the daughter of Edward IV and his beautiful Queen Elizabeth Woodville. Being a girl kept her safe when her two little brothers, Edward V and Richard, the Duke of York, were trapped and became the tragic princes in the Tower held by their uncle, Richard III. When it pays to be a girl. It was rumoured that at one stage she was the object of Richard III's marriage intention. And if he had his own way, she would have been forced to marry her own uncle. That's horrible. However, Elizabeth's mother had allied with Lady Margaret Beaufort, the mother of Henry Tudor, and the two women came up with a plan to have Henry and Elizabeth marry. After Henry invaded and defeated Richard III at the Battle of Bosworth, the new king honoured his mother's schemes and married Elizabeth, thereby uniting the warring houses of York and Lancaster. Thank goodness. Can you imagine having to marry your uncle? That's grim. Elizabeth was a gentle and popular queen, the beloved mother of Arthur, Prince of Wales, and the future Henry VIII. When she died, aged only 37, her husband Henry was said to be overcome. So she seemed to be a nice kind of lady. Edward Plantagenet. Again, we might have read this person, but we'll recap if we have already. Edward Plantagenet, 1475-1499, was the Earl of Warwick. Edward Plantagenet was the son of George, Duke of Clarence, brother of Edward IV and Richard III, and a cousin of Edward V, the Prince in the Tower, who never quite made it to the throne. He was the last of the Plantagenets and the last in the legitimate line from Henry II. However, like his cousin, Edward found himself in the Tower of London, this time at the request of Henry VII. Henry VII saw Edward's claim to the throne as a potential threat, and with the emergence of various other pretenders to the crown, Henry felt more and more anxious to secure his position as king. Eventually, Henry had Edward executed for plotting to escape from the Tower and for conspiring with infamous pretender Perkin Warbeck, who claimed to be the lost prince.